ready to match the stars. Stu Gillum. Brett Summers. Jack Klugman. Stephanie Edwards. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rivers.
Spoobident.
I'm what was that?
Spoobident.
I don't know what that means.
Sufficiently falsified.
Oh. I'll take your word for that.
Better believe.
Veritable Alan Ludden. You're just gorgeous.
Oh, not that. No, I thank you for noticing my presence, and I hope
How could we miss it?
Well, I'm going right to the racetrack after the thing is all over there.
I have bet on better dressed
horses. Seeing our clothiers, right?
Seeing our clothiers, yeah. Would you like to say hello to our two players, Shirley Gunnarsson and Michelle Alexander? This lady is our current champ. She's won one game, has a total cash amount of $600 to her credit, and she has been challenged by Shirley. We started the game last time we were all together, and we finished...
It was 15 minutes
ago. You haven't been all together in 25 years.
We finished one round, and Shirley Gunnarsson has matched two celebrities, and we're about to get to the second half of the second round, and you've got to match two to stay in the game.
Gene has an album coming out with this explanation.
Come back, okay, all right. All right, here we go. Shall we carry on, ladies? Whoops, I pushed the button. There it is. All right, 2-0, favor Shirley. Here we go, Michelle, with your question. Remember, you must match two celebrities to achieve a tie. Are you ready?
Yes.
Everyone will participate.
Sure.
Okay.
Irene said.
Irene!
No, she didn't say that. No, she didn't say that. This is what she said.
What'd she say?
Irene said.
Right.
Every time I dance with Marvin, his blank tickles me.
It certainly do.
What you see is what you get, Irene.
There's a lady in the third row hysterical.
Could I have that question again, Jane? Because
you've been tickled by Marvin, haven't you? Irene said, every time I dance with Marvin, his blank tickles me. You thinking of an answer, Shirley? Don't say it until I call for it. I mean, Michelle, you ready for one? Hold everything. Stu and Brett are still writing.
Not me.
You're ready, Jack.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I'm ready.
Now,
look
Stu,
at
are you ready? Okay, here we go. Michelle, may we call for your response now? Every time I dance with Marvin, his blank tickles me.
His mustache.
Mustache is what she said. You like that answer, eh? Okay. Audience is rooting for mustache. Stu, if you show us a mustache, why, that will score one match for Michelle.
Well, undoubtedly that is correct, because if you have noticed my beautifully manicured mustache, some people have difficulty finding it black on black, but mustache is what I wrote, and spelling is what I had on it.
You need another one to tie the game. Three, however, will win it. Brett, what have you got up there?
Would you believe I was already all the way down at the other end of the field?
Oh, really?
It's buttons.
Your buttons. Okay. Let me see now.
Would you believe?
I gotta get this picture. Marvin and Shirley are dancing.
No, Gene, they haven't danced that close together in years.
What is okay.
I don't know. Is in the name.
You know that Irene really tickled him. Brett usually tickles me with her mustache.
Mustache.
And that's all we're going
to got a tie going now. One more mustache, Michelle, and you'll win the game. Stephanie, may we see your mustache?
I was told...
Or whatever you got.
I was told to be clean and funny.
Clean and funny.
And I can't do both.
Give it up.
It's got to be one or the other. So I'm going for clean.
All
with
right.
With a bow tie.
Bow tie tickles me. Not a bad answer. Okay, Richard.
Not a good answer.
And not a funny answer.
It was the worst answer that I've ever seen.
You could be tickled by a bow tie dancing with somebody.
Maybe all right. So, but
not if you married Alan Ludden, you can't.
He's got to be awful tall. He's got to be awful tall if he's going to tickle you with his bow tie.
What was that? Richard, would you like to participate?
Well, I certainly would.
Why don't we tell our wives we're in Tijuana? He tickled her with his beard.
Beard and mustache. You got a match?
Cheetah beard.
No, wait a minute. No, that's, the judge says that is not a match, and we have to abide by his decision. Now, if Betty comes up with a mustache, you win the game.
The polyandry.
Now listen, let's stay calm, everybody. Mustache!
I enjoyed it. Thank you, everyone.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. We've got a gift for you. Let's say goodbye to Shirley Gunnarsson. Goodbye, Shirley. Here you are again, Michelle.
I thought she was pregnant.
Tell everybody that she's
pregnant.
Tell
everybody.
Tell everybody.
I'm pregnant.
She said that the first day she was with us, and that's I got to take her word for it. Because
I'm paying my doctor, I better be. My doctor's getting paid now, too.
Really? I don't care to explore the subject any further. She's expecting a baby sometime in January. We wish you the best of luck in that event.
She did say pay, didn't she?
And here, yes. Here we go with the super match, Michelle. You know how this goes. You've done it before. We polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank bells. The answer given most often by that studio audience is worth $500 if you can match it. And their second most frequent response, if you match it, is $250, and the third, $100. Okay, now you can get solicit three answers from three celebrities, one at a time.
Richard?
Richard Dawson, how do you fill in that blank there?
Church bells.
Church bells.
Oh, I said it first.
Oh, you said it first. Yeah, I thought I heard it somewhere. He said church bells. There's one answer for you.
Stu?
I think jingle bells.
Jingle bells.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was only one word, friends.
Yes. All right, you got two. One more to go.
Brett? I'm up. I had jingle. And he said it. I can't think of a single solitary thing. Christmas bells.
Christmas bells. Okay, she said it as the buzzer sounded, so we'll just leave it at that. So you've got jingle bells, Christmas bells, and church bells. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own answers, but we need an answer now.
I think I'll go with Stu and jingle.
Jingle bells is what she says. Okay.
You will jingle.
I say you will. All right. We are looking for jingle bells. May we see the $100 response? Hell's bells.
I was pretty close.
Yes. That was some wild audience. Where'd you get that audience, Johnny Olson? Was it a group like this?
Somebody buy that audience a compass.
Yeah. All right, we're still looking for jingle bells. May we see the $250 response? Wedding bells, a very good answer that nobody
thought. Am I out of it? I never thought of that.
Okay. Now, here's your third and last chance, Michelle. Looking for jingle bells, may we see the $500 response?
Jingle bells!
Okay. So you've got the $500. That means you're up to $1,200 in cash, and now you're going for the big money. 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, to collect the $5,000, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Please choose a celebrity now.
I think I should stick with Stu.
Yes.
I think you should.
Stick with Stu. That even...
Nice thing to
Yeah, that's got very good sound to it. Okay. Stu, you get ready to write, and you're going to face me.
I have to write this one.
You got to write this one, right.
That's a rumor around town, honey.
It's worth $5,000. Here it is, Stu. Fill in this blank. Swimming blank. Swimming blank. All right, Stu has finished his answer. Michelle, now we call for yours. How do you fill in that blank? Swimming?
Pool.
Swimming pool? All right, Stu, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Jane, I really don't know how to tell you this. What? I really don't know how to tell Goodson and Todman this. But they can both stick one hand in their pocket. Come on out!
Okay, here we go. Let's say hello to a new player. Here is Dawn Blakeney.
Hello, Dawn. You know Michelle.
Where are you from, Dawn?
I live in Thousand Oaks.
You want to tell us a little more than that?
Yes, I'm an ex-police radio dispatcher.
An ex-what?
Police radio dispatcher.
Oh.
And I'm married to a police officer, going to cosmetology school now, and working on my bachelor's degree in psychology.
Okay.
Well, anything you say will be held down in the train.
Well, good luck to you, Dawn.
Thank you.
Know that you and Michelle will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. And
what's the joke? Everybody plays.
All right, Stu. You may sit in your chair the way the rest of us do.
I honestly believe I don't want nothing to do with this game. I decline to answer.
Okay, and the one who has matched the most celebrities at the end of the second round will be the winner and gets $100 for that, and then has a chance to go on to the super match where you can win a great, great deal of money, as she just did. Okay, would you please make a selection? Something funny happened here, and I don't know what it is.
We'll
figure it out later. Dawn?
B, please.
B. All right. Some contestants find these harder than others, and that's why we ask you to make the selection. Everyone participates.
Nobody lays off, as they say.
That's right. Layout is the expression when you do not participate. Jack asked Brett to warm his blank. Jack asked Brett to warm his blank.
Kiss me.
Oh, heavens. I think I've been married too long.
I can't tell a lie. The only other thing she ever warmed was my temper.
Jack asked Brett to warm his blank.
Jill came tumbling in.
Already? Okay. Now, let's see how Dawn handles this question. Jack asked Brett to warm his blank, Dawn.
Bed, she said.
Okay, Stu. She's looking for the word bed. May we see your card, please?
She may continue on because in a relationship between two fellas, the only thing that another fella can warm for me is some coffee.
Coffee.
Are you saying I'm another fella?
Jack and Brett, you see.
Jack and Brett. Not Jack and Tony. Jack and Brett.
Brett. Oh, well, he didn't say Brett.
Yes.
I thought it was B-R-E-T.
All right.
Wrong. Again.
May we see yours?
Yes. Warm his back.
Warm his back.
Yeah.
All right.
That's a lie. She never could warm my back, and she can never warm my feet.
Warm his feet. All right. Dawn's answer is bed. Stephanie, what's yours?
I'm so pleased to find that ex-policewomen and psychologists and lovely young ingenues think alike.
Would you like to try for the job?
Well, my question is your place or mine?
Never mind.
Well, I've been trying to find out who they were. Warm the seat.
No match there. You scored once, Dawn. And now let's see how Betty White handled it.
She's also in dermatology, and I don't understand how she can be married to a cop and be in a skin game. I don't understand it. Coffee, I said.
Coffee. So you scored once with that, and now let's see how Michelle does with this. Again, everyone plays. Helen said, before we go any further, Steve, I think I should tell you I'm blank.
What's that now?
Pull it out there.
Get rid of that audio.
Could I have that question again,
Helen
please,
said,
sweetheart?
Helen said, before we go any further, Steve, I think I should tell you I'm blank. Betty's ready?
Betty's always ready.
Betty's always ready.
After the show, we'll talk. Okay? Now, they're all set, Michelle, so may we call for your response. Helen said, before we go any further, Steve, I think I should tell you I'm...
married.
Married. That's her answer, married. Stu, what's yours?
My answer?
Your answer.
Is, oh, well, osmosis working one more time, because that's the only thing you're really concerned about, you understand? When you're 5'7", if football players are her liking, you want to know whether she married.
That's right. Okay, there's one match, and now we go to Brett.
I frankly don't give a damn one way or the other, but I did say married.
Oh, you do? All right. There's two for you and Jack Klugman.
That was the least of her problems. She was worried about being pregnant.
I see. That seems to be the audience's response there. Well, Stephanie?
Yes, that's my response, too.
Pregnant is her answer. Richard?
I probably have the cause, then, of the pregnancy. Al Drunko.
Before I go any further, Steve, I think I should tell you I'm drunk.
Gene, if she's already pregnant, your problem is over.
That's right. Betty White.
Well, it's Michelle who's gotten us into all this trouble, and vice versa. Pregnant.
Pregnant. All right, so at this moment, the score is 2-1 at the end of round one. We'll go to round two, ladies, right after we go to this. All right, we've just finished round one. Score is 2-1 in favor of our current champ. Let's go to round two here. Dawn, would you please make a selection?
Be again.
Be again. Now, last time out, Dawn, you matched Stephanie, so you'll be trying to match everyone but Stephanie this time. Leonard works in a prune factory. His job is to blank them. Leonard works in a prune factory. His job is to blank them.
Quickly, we all got ready.
Everybody's ready. Everybody ready. All right, let's go over here to Dawn and find out what Leonard does in this prune factory. What does he do, Dawn?
Pit them.
He pits prunes. You think that's the only answer? There are a lot of other and good answers to that. But we'll find out now. She says he pits prunes.
Yes,
Stu.
And what? You have said that there are a lot of other good answers.
Yes.
I couldn't think of one of them. That's why I put pit.
Oh, you put pit too. Okay. He was a prune pitter.
Well, one of the good answers is shrivel, but I didn't put shrivel, I put pit.
There's another. So we have two prune pitters.
Whatever he does there to the prunes, he does it sitting down. He pits.
He's a prune pitter, okay? So we have...
I don't understand that.
A lot of prune pitters today.
Stephanie, you have a lot of
match.
Prunes?
Let's
and
get
stand
to
up?
Richard Dawson.
A lot of people don't know that prunes are very round and smooth. They're made by Mattel. And he wrinkles them.
He's a prune wrinkler.
That's a messy job. Messy.
Yeah. Okay.
Now,
here's the last chance to get a prune pitter from Betty White.
He works next to this beautiful girl, you see, and every time she comes in, he's kind of a pitter-patter, is what he does. But he's a seeder. That's the same as pit.
Same thing.
Same thing.
Seed
same
takes the
thing.
Seed out and takes the pits out. Okay, there's a match. Okay.
Oh, remember that
so you're
film.
Up to five, Dawn. Now you have two, Michelle. That means you must score three times in order to achieve a tie. Four, however, will win the game. And before we get to your question, we're going to get to this. We've got to quit for now. Our time has just about expired.
Oh, really?
And so have we.
Not a moment too soon.
That's right. It's 5-2 in favor of our challenger. And you have one question to go, and we'll do that next time. Now, you're our current champ. You know, you've got $6,200, and we'll look forward to seeing both of you ladies next time. And we'll look forward to seeing all of your bodies next time, too.
No.
But before we go, I want to find out about Stu's new show, which is going to be on the air in a month or so, this fall, isn't it?
This fall.
What's the name of it?
The name of the show is Rollout.
Rollout.
Rollout. It comes on... Really, it's funny, you see, because we're on exactly opposite,
same
Jack
time.
And the Odd Couple, on 8:30 Saturday night. And we would advise everybody at this time, to go out and buy two television sets because neither one of us can afford to lose.
Okay.
Gene Rayburn saying so long to Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are a timely gift from Westcloth. 17 Jewel Man's calendar wristwatch, water-resistant case, and radial brush dial from Westcloth's Italian Industries Company. And Snowy Bleach, the exclusive blended formula with extra washes per box, safe for whites and colors, Snowy Bleach. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dish is so quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Get ready to match the stars. Stu Gillum. Brett Somers. Jack Klugman. Stephanie Edwards. Richard Dawson. We play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
All right. You are expubitant.
I meant, what was that?
Expubitant.
I don't know what that means.
Sufficiently falsified.
Oh. I'll take your word for that.
Better you're believe.
Veritable Alan Ludden. You're just gorgeous.
Oh, not that. No, I thank you for noticing my presence, and I hope
how you're... could we miss it?
Well, I'm going right to the racetrack after the thing is all over there.
I have bet on better dressed horses.
Our clothiers, right?
Seeing our clothiers, yeah. Would you like to say hello to our two players, Shirley Gunnarsson and Michelle Alexander? This lady is our current champ. She's won one game, has a total cash amount of $600 to her credit, and she has been challenged by Shirley. We started the game last time we were all together, and we finished...
15 minutes
you haven't been all together in 25 years.
We finished one round, and Shirley Gunnarsson has matched two celebrities, and we're about to get to the second half of the second round, and you've got to match two to stay in the game.
Gene has an album coming out with this explanation.
Come back, okay, all right. All right, here we go. Shall we carry on, ladies? Whoops, I pushed the button. There it is. All right, 2-0, favor Shirley. Here we go, Michelle, with your question. Remember, you must match two celebrities to achieve a tie. Are you ready?
Yes.
Yeah. Everyone will participate.
Sure.
Okay.
Irene said.
Irene.
No, she didn't say that. No, she didn't say that. This is what she said.
What'd she say?
Irene said.
Why?
Every time I dance with Marvin, his blank tickles me.
It certainly do.
What you see is what you get, Irene.
There's a lady in the third row hysterical.
Could I have that question again, Gene? Because
you've been tickled by Marvin, haven't you? Irene said, every time I dance with Marvin, his blank tickles me. You thinking of an answer, Shirley? Don't say it until I call for it. Michelle, you ready for one? Hold everything. Stu and Brett are still writing.
Not me.
You're ready, Jack.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I'm ready.
Now,
look
Stu,
at
are you ready? Okay, here we go. Michelle, may we call for your response now? Every time I dance with Marvin, his blank tickles me.
His mustache.
Mustache is what she said. You like that answer, eh? Okay. audience is rooting for Mustache. Stu, if you show us a mustache, why, that will score one match for Michelle.
Well, undoubtedly that is correct, because if you have noticed my beautifully manicured mustache, some people have difficulty finding it black on black, but mustache is what I wrote, and all spelling right, is what
one.
I had.
You need another one to tie the joint. We've got a gift for you. Let's say goodbye to Shirley Gunnison. Goodbye, Shirley. Here you are again, Michelle.
I thought she was pregnant.
Tell everybody that she's
she had the baby.
Tell everybody.
I'm pregnant.
She said that the first day she was with us, and that's I got to take her word for it. Because
I'm paying my doctor, I better be. My doctor's getting paid now, too.
Really? I don't care to explore the subject any further. She's expecting a baby sometime in January. We wish you the best of luck in that event.
She did and say also, pay, yeah, didn't she?
And here, yes. Here we go with the super match, Michelle. You know how this goes. You've done it before. We polled a previous studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank bells. The answer, given most often by that studio audience, is worth $500 if you can match it. And their second most frequent response, if you match it, is $250, and the third, $100. Okay, now you can solicit three answers from three celebrities, one at a time.
Richard?
Richard Dawson, how do you fill in that blank there?
Church bells.
Church bells.
Oh, I said it first.
Oh, you said it first. Yeah, I thought I heard it somewhere. He said church bells. There's one answer for you.
Stu?
I think jingle bells.
Jingle bell.
Yay!
Okay.
That was only one word, friends.
Yes. All right, you got two. One more to go.
Brett? I'm up. I had jingle. And he said it. I can't think of a single solitary thing. Christmas bells.
Christmas bells. Okay, she said it as the buzzer sounded, so we'll just leave. Game three, however, will win it. Brett, what have you got up there?
Would you believe I was already all the way down at the other end of the field?
Oh, really?
It's buttons.
Your buttons. Let me see
would
now.
Would you
let me just,
believe?
I gotta get this picture. Marvin and Shirley are dancing.
Says, no, Gene, they haven't danced that close together in years.
What is okay. I don't know.
Is in the name.
You know that Irene really tickled him. Brett usually tickles me with her mustache.
Mustache.
And that's all a good
one. We've got a tie going now. One more mustache, Michelle, and you win the game. Stephanie, may we see your mustache?
I was told.
Or whatever you got.
Oh, I was told to be clean and funny.
Clean and funny.
And I can't do both.
Give it up.
It's got to be one or the other. So I'm going for clean.
All
with
right.
The bow tie.
Bow tie tickles me. Not a bad answer. Okay, Richard.
Not a good answer.
And not a funny answer.
I think it's one of the worst answers I've ever seen.
You could be tickled by a bow tie dancing with somebody.
Maybe all right. So, but
not if you married Alan Ludden, you can't.
He's got to be awful tall. He's got to be awful tall if he's going to tickle you with his bow tie.
What was that? Richard, would you like to participate?
Well, I certainly would. Why don't we tell our wives we're in Tijuana? You tickle her with a beard.
Beard and mustache. You got a match?
Indeed a beard.
No, we don't know. That's the judge says that is not a match, and we have to abide by his decision. Now, if Betty comes up with a mustache, you win the game.
The polyandry.
Now listen.
Don't be nervous now.
Let's stay calm, everybody. Mustache.
I enjoyed them. Thank you, everyone.
Well, I'm glad you leave it at that. So you've got jingle bells, Christmas bells, and church bells. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own answers, but we need an answer now.
I think I'll go with Stu and jingle.
Jingle bells is what she says. Okay.
You will jingle.
I say you will. All right. We are looking for jingle bells. May we see the $100 response? Hell's bells.
I was pretty close.
That was some wild audience. Where'd you get that audience, Johnny Olson? Was it a group like this?
Somebody buy that audience a compass.
Yeah. All right, we're still looking for jingle bells. May we see the $250 response? Wedding bells, a very good answer.
anniversary that nobody...
Oh, am I out of it? I never thought of that.
Okay. Now, here's your third and last chance, Michelle. Looking for jingle bells, may we see the $500 response.
Jingle bells!
Okay. So you've got the $500. That means you're up to $1,200 in cash, and now you're going for the big money. 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, to collect the $5,000, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Please choose a celebrity now.
I think I should stick with Stu.
Yes.
I think you should.
Stick with Stu. That even...
Nice ring to
it. Yeah, that's got a very good sound to it. Okay. Stu, you get ready to write, and you're going to face me.
I have to write this one.
You got to write this one, right.
That's a rumor around town, honey.
It's worth $5,000. Here it is, Stu. Fill in this blank. Swimming blank. Swimming